traveling opens size and broadens horizons in so many different ways. It's hard to predict what you learn along the way. In India, sand mining is a very controversial issue, which caught my attention. And today, I wanted to share it with you.
Do you know that sand is one of the most vital resources, right after water and oil? Do you know that price of a sand can be on the same level as price of crude oil? Do you know that the sand mafia is stealing beaches and islands to get that resource?
I was surprised myself, and even though sand is one of the most traded commodities in our planet, there is still very low awareness about volume and effects of its extraction. Our civilization is built on sand, and we use it in so many different ways.
Whole cities are built from it. It is the main aggregate in the production of asphalt and concrete. It is used for electronic equipment like laptops or cell phones. Without it, there will be no glass or light bulbs. It is in a toothpaste we use. Even we can find it in silicone that supports our underwear.
It is commonly used. And as there is more and more people on the planet, the demand is increasing as globalization progresses. And at this point, I guess you wonder, where is the problem? Sand is everywhere around us. Why don't we take it from the desert?
That's impossible. It turns that sand from the desert is functionally useless, as it's too perfect, too smooth, too rounded to be able to work into concrete, which is our main need. The best sand to be used is jagged, angular, and it comes from the lakes, riverbeds, riverbanks, and oceans. Globally, yearly, we extract around 53 billion tons, the equivalent to every person on Earth using 20 kilos of sand every single day. India, after China, is one of the biggest global leaders on infrastructure and construction, and most probably that is why it is the critical hotspot for sand extraction.
Sand can command a high price. That is why it attracts attention of criminals. Sand mafias illegally drench sand from prohibited areas. Where is mafia? They are victims. And that reminds me a situation of gold diggers from back in the days.
The black market only in India could be generating revenue of around $204 million yearly. Effects? It hurts the biodiversity of ecosystems and wildlife. Whole islands disappear, and in India, some of the beaches in Goa and Kerala. In some cases, it affects water supply, while already millions of people face water shortages. Or, on the contrary, it causes floods, as eliminating sand lowers the river protection. We, humans, tend to believe we own the earth. Resources are unlimited, and we can exploit planet without any consequences. But in this case, we extract sand 3 times faster than nature can replenish it.
And for what? We are building artificial islands, some in the shape of palms, and skyscrapers built on extended shores. And
there is a question. Where is the balance in between satisfying needs of our growing population to have homes which serve a necessary function and building as a symbol of prestige? Do we need all of that? Our demands are increasing, and the nature simply can't renew itself that fast.
We get signals about it from the nature more and more. Global warming, ice is melting, forests are burning, plastic covers oceans, and in some environmental topics, we are more aware. But actually, when we take a closer look, the list is longer than that, and that makes me wonder if all these problems can't be put into one single word, which is overconsumption. Yes, I'm walking.
A balance.
Oh yes, it's a balance thing.
Enough.
I managed.
Stop, don't come too
years
close.
Of practice yoga, and now I can work as a construction worker. If you like my videos, subscribe at Anna Nagot. Happy travels! I love you.